So I had a lock get hung up on the left side there. Had to work with it for a minute. Man, I get a lot of engine noise from my radio. I'm gonna have to work on that a little bit. We just turned that down in here. So once we see that all this works, then I can work on getting these wires teamed up a little bit. Okay, so we got a little bit of ground fog this morning. We had a nice hole open up at the airport, so we were able to get up the ground. We were able to maintain a clear visual with the ground at all times and stay clear of clouds. So off we go. Yeah, anyway, guys, it's been busy. Man, we've had a lot of students kind of back-to-back. We've had two father and son teams learn to fly, and I got another father and son team starting tomorrow, actually, yeah. So, exciting times. We've been flying a lot of just local area because the winds aloft tend to be strong. We went to Sun N Fun Expo at Lakeland this year. Talked to a lot of people, made a lot of new friends, had a lot of fun. Did an ass load of tandem flights. Holy cow. We were just going tandem back to back to back every morning. My partner Tony was helping out. I'd land with a passenger and get him unloaded. He'd have another one ready to go. He'd lay the wing out for me, get him strapped in. I didn't even get out of the trike. We'd do another one, just back to back to back. So it was a lot of fun. Got to share with a lot of people. A lot of new equipment coming in. We just got a new load of the C2 trikes. Those are pretty awesome. That's a tandem or single trike. It's just a little bit smaller than this Diamond. It can take the Moster 185 or the Cosmos 300. And I tell people with the Cosmos, it's a sports car. It's an absolute beast. And we got a new load of Scorpios and Crafter Trikes in. So I've been flying the Scorpio a good bit on the Crafter Trike. Northeast, and we'll go ahead and trim out. Then our trim's out. I've been flying a Scorpio on the Crafter Trike, putting it through its paces, and I'm real happy with that setup. I've been using it as a school unit, as a training setup, and I've had a couple guys have some minor general rollovers, and it's come through without any damage. Just incredible.
All right, Narnia.
1 o'clock. Thank you. Well, that wasn't so hard to find now, was it? And Big Sean informed me that turkey season is over, so I don't have to worry about disturbing any hunters. Man, the creek is dry. I'm kind of surprised. We had some pretty good rain yesterday. I guess I have to fill up the swamp first. Let's dip in here and take a go. Oh, there's some cows all the way down. Yeah, we don't want to freak the cows out. Damn, it's cold down here. Yeah, the creek is done dried up. You can make phone calls and talk to people and all kinds of crazy stuff. Okay, well, anyway, we've been working on building up inventory. We got plenty of foot launch paramotors, we got plenty of trikes. We got brand new diamond trikes, tandem with the Cosmos 300 like this. We've got C2 trikes with either the Cosmos 300 or the Motion 185. One hell of a machine. We are super proud of that one. The guys at Craft Paramotor in Argentina worked with us to design that one. The original design was the C1, and there were some things that it was a good trike, but there were some things we thought could be better. And the guys at Craft agreed with us, so they came up with the C2 trike, and it is an awesome flying machine. We're super psyched about it. To get some aerial video, some higher quality video, with something other than the GoPro or the 360 camera. Sunglasses are great, the problem is they're polarized. Hunting season's over. Turkey season's over. out here. We try to be courteous when the season's in. So, what's on the schedule next? Sun N Fun is over. Next is the Bad Apples flying at Mack Hodges Field at Americas, Georgia. Really psyched for that one. That's probably our biggest flying of the year. It's been known to have 300 or so pilots. If you guys come look us up at Bad Apples, I'll be doing introductory rides, tandem rides out there for sure. We'll have some inventory with us, some new Paramotors, foot launch, and trike support. We're trying a new engine. It's the EOS 150. It is, as I'm told, very, very similar, almost an exact copy of the very popular Roadster 185. It's 26 horsepower. I'm interested to get one on the thrust table and see how it compares. Hopefully we can do that at Bad Apples, but come by and check them out. We got a few of them out there, and we just got to put them through the paces and see how they work.